DMVSTREAM.COM presents exclusive coverage of the 2015 National High School Hoops Festival live from the Brendan Looney Convocation Center on the campus of DeMatha Catholic High School in Hyattsville, Maryland. Good morning, everybody. This is Sean Parker along with Josh Apple. Josh, we have got a long and but exciting day of basketball here at DeMatha.
Right, we do. It's very exciting. We have 14 teams here today. In this first game, two relatively local teams, Chavez out of D.C. and Laurel out of Maryland, but there's nine teams from Maryland, one from D.C., two from Virginia, and, I mean, there's a team coming all the way from Texas, so should be a really good day here.
Well, we're going to get started here. The first game we've got today, Cesar Chavez and Laurel, and what can we expect today from these two teams?
Yeah, we have some really high-profile teams here today, certainly some of the later games, but this first game is no slouch. Chavez is a team loaded with really good guards. They like to really play fast and up the tempo, and you should see a pretty high-paced, high-scoring game with them. And Laurel, it'll be up to them to handle the Chavez pressure, because Chavez likes to pressure the ball defensively and really play up tempo, so Laurel will have to be ready for that and handle the pressure.
All right, we're going to get underway here in just a moment. We're just about ready for the tip, so we're going to go down to the court. With our starting lineups for Cesar Chavez, we have Khalif Tate, Greg Blaine, Jacob Long, Omari Haygood, and Prince Wright. Cesar Chavez running a five-guard lineup. As a matter of fact, all of their players are guards.
All their players are guards. Very unusual. Khalif Tate is the star of the group there, a really good guard.
All right. And it is Cesar Chavez that controls the tip. Good passing. Three-pointer, no good. The rebound to Jeremiah Pittman, and we have a stoppage.
Quick whistle here. Trying to see what the call is.
All right, the starting lineup, while we have a moment here for Laurel, we've got Antoine Matthews. We have Jeremiah Pittman on the court. Eno, Kirk Hawkins. And we have another whistle. And we have a foul.
Here you see the little starting lineup there in white today. The home team, Chavez in black, sporting some nice black and red uniforms today.
And Laurel in the white with the blue and yellow trim. That is Kirk Hawkins with the basketball. Passing inside, out to Eno. Short jumper, and we have our first 2 points of the game.
Nice mid-range jumper there. It's a good sign for them.
And a three-point outside. That is Mike Starks. And we have a foul underneath. That foul is going to be on number zero, Khalif Tate, his first.
Khalif Tate, as I mentioned, is their star. He's averaging over 20 points a game. Really big-time scorer, big-time player for them, so he needs to make sure not to get into foul trouble early.
Pressure by Chavez. Laurel able to break the pass. Press, it is Eno. Driving in and scoring, and he's got two quick buckets. Laurel is up 4-0.
Yeah, Laurel handled the Chavez pressure well there, and they've hit some open shots, so two of their keys they're handling well so far.
Khalif Tate. Over on the right side, Jacob Long. And there's a three-pointer by Greg Blaine. He misses. Long rebound out to Tate. Underneath, Omari Haygood unable to get it to go. Battling underneath, and that is Khalif Tate. And Chavez on the boards early.
Yeah, how about that? Chavez, a team that doesn't have a player over 6'3", getting on the boards.
And we have a foul on Chavez. That foul is going to be on Greg Blaine.
Greg Blaine's another player to watch for them. A really good guard to go along with Khalif Tate. A great 1-2 punch there.
The Laurel Spartans out of Laurel, Maryland. And there's a steal. Going back the other way. That was Mike Starks with the jumper. Over on the wing, Prince Wright for three.
Yeah, and that was all set up by the Chavez pressure that I mentioned earlier in the game. As you see, there caused another turnover.
And that was a rather careless turnover right there for Kirk Hawkins. Chavez will gain possession.
They're doing a good job of forcing the tempo early, which is something Chavez wants to do.
And we have a quick timeout. Coach Torrance Oxendine wants to talk to his team for a moment. While we are in timeout, we would like to remind you that DMVSTREAM.com broadcasts pro, amateur, college, high school, AAU, and youth games in D.C., Maryland, and Virginia live to televisions, computers, and mobile devices like iPads, iPhones, Androids, and more. Find out more at DMVSTREAM.com. All right, so we're going to take a look right now at our keys to the game, and Josh, for Chavez, what are they looking to do?
Yeah, I mentioned on some of these earlier, they like to force the tempo on both ends. As I mentioned, they are a team full of guards, so they have a lot of speed on their team. They want to win the intangibles, such as forcing turnovers like they just did, and they want to match the intensity and energy with a bunch of fast, you know, guards. They are going to play up tempo, and they want to have a lot of intensity, especially on the defensive end.
All right, we are waiting. The officials are at the scorer's table. They are conferring. And while we're doing that, we're going to go to Laurel's keys for the game.
Yeah, going off of what I just said, Laurel needs to handle that Chavez pressure, and they need to hit open shots, which they hit one earlier in the game, a mid-range jumper. That was a nice shot. And they need to hold Chavez under 40% from the field. Chavez has some really good shooters, so that'll be tough to do.
All right, so it looks like we are good to go here. Chavez is going to maintain possession. Chavez head coach Malcolm Battle having a word with the official. And now they are going back to the table. And it looks like a technical foul has been called. Greg Blaine is going to be shooting the technical.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure what happened there.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure. And Coach Oxendine went over to the referee. He was wondering what was going on there. Blaine sinks the two technicals. And Chavez will retain possession.
There's been a lot of stoppages of play and discussions among the referees so far. I'm not quite sure what's going on in the early going here.
Let's see if that's going to affect either one of the teams going forward. Jacob Long over to Blaine on the right side. Good ball movement on the perimeter. Blaine looking to set the offense. No shot clock. Over on the right side. That was Khalif Tate with a three. No good. Rebound to Oba and Joran.
Tate's a good shooter, but he wasn't able to knock that one down.
And there's a good pass on the left side. Inside with the layup, and that's good.
Steal there by Laurel, giving Chavez a piece of their own medicine and defensive pressure. Chavez is a very perimeter-oriented team, as you see, especially while they're being zoned.
Three-pointer on the way. Jacob Long buries it. And Chavez has a 10-6 lead.
Jacob Long's another good shooter. Tate, Blaine, and Long are the three players to watch for them.
Drive. Kurt Hawkins. Count the basket and the foul. That foul is going to go on number 15, Prince Wright. That will be his first.
That was a nice move there. He took the contact, absorbed it, and finished and made the basket. Tough play.
Checking into the game now for Laurel is Keyshawn Hill Kearney, 6'1 junior guard. Hawkins at the line.
Three-point play. Very nicely done.
Free throw shooting on all levels of basketball, so important. Khalif Tate on the right side. Laurel in a zone. Chavez looking for a hole in that zone. Tate having some trouble, pressured. Gets it over on the left side. Inside, Omari Haygood, no good.
That was rebound really good to ball moving. Really good ball movement there, but they weren't able to finish.
And there's a foul in the backcourt. Haygood trying to pick the pocket of Kirk Hawkins, and he commits the foul. The opening game of the 2015 National High School Hoops Festival, Cesar Chavez and Laurel, 10-9 in the early going. And there's a turnover out of bounds. Keyshawn Hill Kearney could not handle the basketball. Chavez with the possession.
A bit of some sloppy play early, but both these teams are really good at defensive pressure, so they are forcing these turnovers.
Tate over to Long. Chavez content on the perimeter right now. Tate right in the corner. Back to Tate right in the corner. Teeing up for three. No good. That rebound to Anjorin. Anjorin with a couple of strong rebounds early. Hawkins driving through the lane. Blocking foul called on Chavez, and they are going to give that foul to Jacob Long.
Something interesting to note so far, Chavez is staying on the perimeter and shooting a lot of threes versus Laurel is getting to the inside, making mid-range jumpers and driving and drawing fouls. So a bit of an advantage there scheme-wise so far with Laurel.
Kirk Hawkins at the line, the 5'9 senior. Laurel looking to even their record this year. They are 1-2 coming into this game, and Hawkins sinks the first.
5'9" gives some hope to us little guys. Although I think we would both probably rather be 5'9".
Yeah, I would take 5'9" any day of the week.
I would take 5'9" any day of the week as well. That's why we're not on the court.
Hawkins sinks both free throws, and Laurel has taken a 1-point lead, 11-10. Laurel back in that 2-3 zone. Chavez looking for the answer. They want to penetrate. And there's a turnover, a steal. Keyshawn Hill-Kearney. Laurel comes back the other way. Matthews being double-teamed. Gets it over to Hawkins. Hawkins is going to drive down the lane. No good. Rebound to Chavez. Up ahead to Prince Wright. They turn the ball over, and back comes Antoine Matthews for Laurel. Hawkins, baseline. Another turnover. There is a travel. Chavez ball.
What an exciting game so far, tempo-wise. Both teams are really looking to push the ball, but the defensive pressure by each team has been phenomenal, so baskets are tough to come by.
Tell you one thing about Laurel, and I had the opportunity to watch Laurel a little earlier this year. Always active with the hands, always active with the feet. And most basketball coaches will tell you, you play defense with your feet.
They are coming off two losses to Largo and Old Mill the last couple games, so I know they want to look to get back in the winner's column here.
Skip pass across. Blaine with the jumper. No good. Rebound Hawkins. Over to Arthur Prince. Prince driving. And there's the foul. It looks like they're going to get Mike Starks on that one.
Fouls are starting to rack up a little bit for Chavez. Laurel's doing a great job of getting to the rim.
Arthur Prince to the free throw line, the 5'10 junior guard, making his first appearance at the line today. Just rims in and out.
That did everything but go in. As you mentioned, free throws are a key, especially if this game's going to be close down the stretch.
Second free throw. And I've noticed that on both of the free throws, Laurel doesn't put anyone at the line. They've got their defense back and ready for Chavez.
Yeah.
There's a three-pointer in the corner. That was no good by Troy Johnson. Wright kicking it out. Tate on the left side. His jumper is no good. Rebound, Matthews. Laurel looking to push. Matthews driving the lane. And we've got a loose ball foul, and it looks like they're going to get Oba and Joran on that foul. And it's going back the other way, Chavez ball.
Chavez continues to be a little jump shot happy. I know they have some really good shooters in Tate and Blaine and Long, and they are going against the zone, which makes you shoot a little more than you necessarily want to, but you need to see if they can get inside a little here and penetrate.
Eno checking back into the game for Laurel. Chavez on the outside. Cross-court pass, Tate over to Starks in the corner. That Laurel defense just will not let them inside. Tate with the drive, no good. Eno with the rebound. Chavez just cannot find a hole in that Laurel zone. Hawkins tried to get cute in the backcourt. Oh, and a missed layup by Blaine. Back the other way comes Laurel. On the wing, Hill-Kearney. No. Rebound. Arthur Prince hitting the boards, and he draws contact and will go to the line.
That was a good follow-up there. I know that was off a missed shot, but once again, Laurel's getting looks from inside, and Chavez so far isn't.
So Laurel, with their penetration, they are able to get to the line, and they are manufacturing points. They currently have a two-point lead with just under 2 minutes left to go in the first quarter.
Free throws again. He missed one earlier and just missed one there, too.
Second free throw for Prince on the way. Rims in and out.
They caught a break.
It's going to stay right here. Mike Starks could not quite get the handle on that rebound. Tried the bounce pass inside. Chavez back the other way on the break. They pull it back out in the corner. Greg Blaine for three. Air ball. Rebounded by Arthur Prince. Back comes Laurel. Hawkins with the spin move. And Laurel trying to get the ball into Anjorin, but Chavez not having any of it. And we've got a foul. Blocking foul, and it looks like they're going to get Kirk Hawkins on that one.
On the last possession, Chavez was in transition. Even then, they looked for the three-point shot. So that's clearly a big part of their offense.
Non-shooting foul, only Laurel's third foul of the quarter. Jeremiah Pittman checking in for Laurel, 6'3 senior. And there's a scramble for the ball on the floor. Laurel gets it, and they're going back the other way. One of those 50-50 balls right there. Hawkins. Eno. Going to take a three. No. And Joran had that rebound, but it was taken away by Keleaf Tate. He comes back the other way. Try to bounce pass off of Chavez's leg, and it's going to be actually off of Laurel. Chavez is going to get the ball.
The defensive pressure in this game is incredible to watch. Both teams just going after it. Nothing is easy to come by.
This is going to be one of those games you have to be careful trying to force passes. Marquise Kauser making his first appearance in the game. Tate with the jumper, no. Rebound, scramble underneath. And we've got a travel. Jeremiah Pittman had the ball, but he rolled. And that's a no-no. It's going to be Chavez ball.
Tate missed that jumper there. He's averaging over 20 a game. He's a really good shooter. He needs to find his touch here.
And there's a steal. Kirk Hawkins. Laurel gets the handle. We're inside 30 seconds. And it looks like Laurel is going to hold for the final shot of the quarter. Although Chavez put it on the double team, they are pressuring the ball, and we've got a foul. That foul is going to be on Troy Johnson, the junior. And Eno. Name so nice, you got to say it twice. He's going to the line to shoot two.
And once
it's a
one
again, and one, excuse me.
Once again, you see Laurel back trying to stop that Chavez speed.
He gets the first free throw. Laurel takes a three-point lead. 11.2 seconds left to go here in the first quarter. Laurel in the 1-1. Eno sinks both. Laurel with a four-point lead. Chavez. Khalif Tate bringing it up court. Clock winding down. Tate, Kauser, back over to Tate. Jumper, yes! He sinks it just before the buzzer.
What a shot. He had been struggling too so far in the first quarter, and he knocked it down. You know he's the guy that wanted to take that shot there.
So after one quarter of play here, Laurel with a 14-12 lead here in the first game of the National High School Hoops Festival.
It's really exciting first quarter. Not necessarily in terms of scoring, but great defensive pressure, and everything came through hard work there.
All right, we are going to step away for a brief break. We're going to come back here to Laurel and Cesar Chavez right after this.
Ladies and gentlemen, with Georgetown University. This new partnership will result in high-level streaming from a minimum of 50 home games this year, including home football games, men's and women's soccer games, and men's and women's lacrosse games. Now, we're hard at work on the hilltop, building infrastructures at both Shaw and multi-sport fields, installing state-of-the-art equipment, and introducing knowledgeable staff like IT professionals, game day directors and producers, and on-air talent that will create an awesome live viewing experience at guhoyas.com/allaccess. Now, colleges and universities across the country have long experimented with streaming their own games and creating their own content. And while many of you have watched live broadcasts at guhoyas.com before, we're taking the Hoyas broadcasts to the very next level. We're adding in four camera angles, graphics, videos, commercial roll-ins, more on-air talent, sideline reporters, producers, directors, and a whole lot more to make this a great game day experience. So log on to guhoyas.com and watch your favorite Hoyas sports teams in action today.
Now we find Rudy, March rather, to Keegan. Keegan slides it across and it's
a
goal!
That is a brilliant goal!
Goal by Brandon Allen! It was March to Rudy!
High school, second quarter of action. The 2015 National High School Hoops Festival. You are watching Laurel and Cesar Chavez in game one of the festival. There's a turnover, Chavez ball.
For those of you just joining us, these are two teams that are very guard heavy. They don't have a lot of size, but they like to pressure the ball defensively, and both teams have a lot of speed.
Khalif Tate, 6'2 junior guard, setting the offense. Swinging the ball, he's a two-man game with Kowser. Back over to Tate, rebound Anjorin. Oba Anjorin doing a good job keeping Cesar Chavez off the offensive boards. There's a three-pointer in the corner by Eno. Eno, no good. Back the other way, Tate. And it looks like we've got a reach-in foul. And they are going to get Keyshawn Hill Kearney on that foul.
Foul is number three, Keyshawn Hill Kearney.
Inside, Haygood.
There you go.
That was a good interior pass by Troy Johnson on that.
Yeah, exactly. That's what we've been waiting to see from Chavez, to get something in going inside.
And then on the next play, Johnson being a little over-aggressive, and he's going to pick up a foul.
That's what happens sometimes when you're a team all about defensive pressure. Sometimes you get a little overzealous and pick up a cheap foul there.
Tied here at 14. And Chavez in the double bonus. Laurel is going to go to the line to shoot two.
The intensity and energy is there from both teams, especially high school kids. This is early for them. Most of them aren't usually awake yet on a Saturday.
It's a little early for me on a Saturday.
Yeah, it's a little early for me too. I'm not sure I'd be awake yet either.
First free throw is good. And we've got substitutions coming in for Chavez. Blaine, Wright, and Long coming back to the floor.
Eno has a nice stroke at the free throw line. He's made all of his free throws so far.
Good shooters from the floor, they tend to have those good strokes from the free throw line. See Steph Curry.
Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves and compare Eno to Steph Curry.
No, yeah. Not at all, not at all. And there's a jumper by Mike Starks, no good, rebound Laurel. And again, Laurel pushing that pace. Back out, Kirk Hawkins, Eno. Three-pointer, yes.
Maybe he is Steph Curry.
He looked a little Steph Curry-ish right there.
He did, all right.
Laurel with a 19-14 lead. And again, Chavez working on the outside. Haygood with the jumper on the right side, no good. Rebound, we are going to have a foul. And they are going to get Oba Anjorin on that foul, a loose ball foul. Chavez ball.
one of Laurel's key to the games was to hold Chavez under 30% shooting. I don't have the numbers in front of me, but it sure seems that way so far.
It does look like that. And, wow, that looked like a backcourt violation.
I sure thought that was a backcourt violation.
Coach Oxendine, Torrance Oxendine, working on the official on that side. Jumper by Prince Wright. Didn't get it to fall, but he drew the contact. He's going to go to the line to shoot, too.
That was a bit of a bailout foul there. They're struggling to shoot. You need to let them take that shot, not get your arm on them.
Eno with his first foul. Chavez going to the line, and I can't recall, is this their first trip to the line today?
It might be. They haven't been, like I said, they haven't been penetrating much. They've been settling for jump shots, and there he got bailed out. He settled for a jump shot again, but got hit on the arm.
Jeremiah Pittman back in for Laurel. Prince Wright looking for his second free throw. And Chavez cuts the lead to 4. There's a drive by Arthur Prince. Rebound to Starks, and we've got a foul.
Yeah, that foul was on Prince after he missed the shot. He was a little frustrated and reached from behind and grabbed him.
Tell you, the men in the stripes, they're getting a good workout today, huh?
They are, man. There's been a lot of stoppages of play so far. But once again, going back to two teams that really like to pressure the ball defensively, there's going to be more fouls. That one was more of a frustration foul, though.
Mike Starks went to the line, missed the free throw, but gets his own rebound. Chavez with the possession. Blaine. Inside, Haygood could not get that pass, and a good sliding pickup right there from Kirk Hawkins. Eno in the corner for 3, and he strokes another one.
Eno. He's on fire.
And Laurel has opened up their largest lead of 7. In the corner, Blaine for 3. He answers. And the lead is back down to 4.
Good answer there. They've been struggling to shoot, but they finally got one to go there from one of their better shooters, Greg Blaine.
Inside, Hawkins. I tell you, Hawkins and Prince have just been going to the hole every time they get the ball. Down the lane, Chavez trying to answer. Long couldn't get it to fall. Back comes Laurel. So the pace still being picked up here. Hawkins driving to the lane again. He is going to get fouled. And they got Mike Starks on that one.
That's your guy Hawkins. You said he likes to get inside, and he did it again. He's a guy that scored 31 points in our last game. That was a loss to Old Mill, but 31 points, that's pretty impressive. So he's a guy that can certainly fill it up offensively.
Yeah, when you're dropping 30 on the high school level, yeah, you are doing something.
The games aren't even long enough to drop 30, are they?
Exactly.
good stuff there.
Hawkins hits the first free throw. Antoine Matthews and Josh Brown making his first appearance in the game, a 6-foot junior forward.
Hawkins is a really speedy guy. I mean, you've seen it. No one can really stay in front of him. He was an All-Met nominee last year. Really talented player.
Yeah, I was talking to Coach Oxendine. He is very high on Hawkins. 3-pointer, Greg Blaine nicks the front of the rim. Back comes Hawkins again. Down the lane,
wow.
And Hawkins scores.
Did I mention his speed? Man, no one can stay in front of him. There he is again.
Great speed on the defensive end. This is quickly turning into the Kirk Hawkins show as Laurel has opened up a 10-point lead.
It has, yeah.
Pittman drives, no. That ball comes back out. Jacob Long missing. Rebound, Haygood. In the corner, Prince Wright, no. Rebound to Pittman.
They continue to settle for jump shots. They need to see if they can get something going inside like this guy.
Hawkins, back out, 3-pointer. Antoine Matthews, no. Long rebound, Matthews able to get it. Inside, Pittman can't get it to fall, but he is going to the line. And it looks like they got Omari Haygood on that foul.
Pittman's a good rebounder, good defender. Isn't necessarily one of their better offensive players, but you saw he made a good move there and drew the foul.
he misses that first free throw. Laurel, not only an athletic team, but a very intelligent team as well. Five seniors on the team, four of them have been awarded academic scholarships, and they've got a team GPA of 3.4.
That's really impressive. That's not something you see very often. Great accomplishment there for them.
And it just shows Coach Oxendine wants his players to be well-rounded, not only on the court, but off the court as well. There's a foul, and Khalif Tate is going to go to the line. So they got, looks like they got Josh Brown on that foul.
And not only is Laurel intelligent as a team, they're also very involved in community service, I saw. They have a lot of community service projects, some toy drives, some coat drives, so quality players, well-developed by coach there.
I mean, on my day job, we've got one toy drive. Laurel is that Laurel High School team, they're dealing with two toy drives.
And a coat drive. That's impressive.
That really is. I need to learn some time management from them. Laurel with some good passing. Eno in the front court. Couldn't get it to fall. Got his own rebound. But Chavez with the steal back the other way. Greg Blaine with the mid-range jumper he hits. And Chavez is down seven. Pressuring the basketball. And Laurel is very lucky that they didn't turn that ball over right there. And actually, they did. That was just a haphazard pass into the front court.
That was, yeah. They need to be more careful with the ball, especially going against Chavez. But Greg Blaine got that last basket. He averages about 13 points a game. He's missed a few jumpers today, but that one fell for him, which is a good sign.
Chavez, long, over to Blaine on the wing for three. No, strong rebound inside. Khalif Tate, nobody put a body on him, and he was able to get the easy put back. Into the front court, Hawkins again, up underneath, no. Battle for the rebound, Tate up ahead to Prince Wright, that pass just a little bit long. Laurel gets the ball back.
Yeah, some sloppy play at times, but these teams play so fast and like to move the ball so quickly and play up tempo that that's going to happen at times, but it's still exciting to watch.
Just over 2.5 minutes left to go here in the first half. Laurel with a 28-23 lead over Cesar Chavez. You're watching the 2015 National High School Hoops Festival. Game one. And we've got a foul. That foul is on Khalif Tate. And Antoine Matthews, the 5'7 junior, is going to go to the line.
5'7, there you go. He's more on our level.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think I might be able to hang with him for a minute or two. Not on the speed, though.
No, I don't think so. You know who I'd really like to see in a race is Kirk Hawkins and Khalif Tate.
That would be a good one.
That would be an impressive foot race. I'd like to see that.
Free throw is good. 29-23 Laurel. Khalif Tate for three, and he drains it.
There it is. We knew he had it in him. He scored 32 in a game earlier this year. So,
and just like that, a 10-point lead down to three. Matthews, and we've got a turnover. Chavez ball. Eno. Oba and Joran back in the game. So it looks like Laurel wants a little more size back in there.
Size is all relative when you have some of the later games. We have 6'8", 6'9", 6'10", guys that we'll see later this afternoon.
The true big boys. Tate. Back out to Tate for three. No good. And Jordan with another rebound. I tell you, when Jordan is in that game, he is a presence underneath the rim. Also, Caleb Gasparo in for Laurel. That pass underneath Arthur Prince with the layup. And Laurel is up five. But back comes Chavez. And are they going to get the charge? Yes, they are. Greg Blaine, just a little overzealous on that drive, and he is going to pick up the offensive foul.
That was a team charge they drew there. It was a few guys that fell to the ground.
And Chavez with the pressure. But Laurel gets it back. Eno driving, and he is going to draw the foul. Greg Blaine, a little incredulous. He didn't think that he picked that one up. But Eno going to the line to shoot two.
And we know he's a good free throw shooter, so he likes to get to the line. I jinxed him. I got him. The announcer's curse. But he had made four in a row before that, so he's doing okay.
Eno with his second shot on the way.
He's back.
He is indeed back. 32-26. Chavez. Khalif Tate looking for his shot. Baseline. No. Gasparo with the rebound. Back comes Hawkins. And Gasparo turns it over. Right to Haygood. The lead is down to four.
Really nice passing there on the fast break.
Prince. Kicks it out. Pass deflected. Gasparo in the corner. He finds Anjorin. And Anjorin, he traveled. He was looking for that defender behind him to lean, and there was nobody there.
There's no one there. The seat fell out from under him. But there's no one really that can hang with him size-wise for Chavez. So if he gathers himself, you know, he can really do some damage, especially on the rebounding side. He's not necessarily their best offensive player, but if he takes his time and gathers himself, he can do something.
Hill Kearney back in for Laurel. And that was Khalif Tate on the left side. He's going to draw contact. And it looks like they got Caleb Gasparo on that foul, his first. And Tate is going to try to cut into this four-point Laurel lead.
That was the second time they fouled a jump shooter, which is certainly one of the big sins in basketball, especially a good shooter like Tate, although he missed that one.
Got to convert at the free throw line. Antoine Matthews back in for Laurel. So Laurel's got their speedy backcourt back in there.
I mentioned that Tate had a 32-point game earlier this year. That was against Covenant Life. He hit six threes. He's also had games he hit five and seven threes this year.
I tell you, hitting it from outside is definitely going to help. Less than a minute remaining, and there's a turnover. Up ahead, Prince Wright, layup, and it's a two-point lead. So that Chavez defense starting to do a little damage. Matthews tries to split the double team. Another turnover. Another fast break. Haygood down underneath. He scores, and this game is tied.
Well, that changed in a hurry, didn't it?
It certainly did. Hawkins pulling it out. 10 seconds. They're looking for the last shot. Hawkins drives the lane. He scores. And Chavez coming up looking for the last shot. They don't get it off. And Laurel is going to go into the locker room with a two-point lead. But looking over there, Coach Torrance Oxendine is not pleased with the end of this first half.
The end of the first half was all about Chavez defensive pressure making that comeback because they were missing shots. So they finally found a way to score on the inside. But a nice move, Laurel, there to get that last basket.
All right, so we have reached halftime here. And, Josh, that was an entertaining first half.
It was a really entertaining first half. It wasn't necessarily high scoring, although there was a lot of scoring there at the end, but it was all about defensive pressure and really an up-tempo game, forcing a lot of turnovers. It was fun to watch just because the tempo was there.
I mean, what are these two teams going to have to do in the second half if they want to win?
Well, the key for Chavez will be making shots. I don't know their exact field goal percentage, but it was really low. They were really struggling from the outside. And knocking down threes is a huge part of their offense. As I mentioned, Tate's a guy who has 7, 6, 5 threes every game. For Laurel, they need to continue driving. They're doing a good job of getting to the basket and drawing fouls, but they need to control the ball better. They had a lot of turnovers there and didn't handle the Chavez pressure well.
So an entertaining half of basketball. We've got an exciting second half of basketball and an exciting roster of games that we've got going on today. I mean, we've got West Charlotte and Riverdale Baptist coming up after this. So that's going to be an exciting intra intrastate, interstate matchup? I always get interstate.
I'm not touching that one, but yeah, West Charlotte out of North Carolina, Riverdale, a local team. Like I said, there's 9 teams from Maryland, 1 from North Carolina, just West Charlotte, but there's teams coming from all over the country, and it will be a really exciting day. The next game will be great, and some really high-profile games as the day goes on. The night games will be phenomenal. Not that these early games are slouches by any means, but some phenomenal games later in the day.
All right, we're going to step away. We're going to take a brief break here. We're going to come back with some first-half highlights and then get you to the second half of action. You're watching Game 1 of the 2015 National High School Hoops Festival here at DeMatha on DMVSTREAM.com. Sean Parker, Josh Apple back here at DeMatha High School. One of the banners over here says that where basketball lives, and basketball certainly did live here in the first half. We've got some highlights for you in the first half, and I tell you, this was just a very entertaining first half for Cesar Chavez. Well, actually, let's start with Laurel since they had lead. Actually, here are our highlights. And early on, Arthur Prince driving it to the hoop, and Laurel getting inside.
They did a great job of getting inside. Chavez was settling for jump shots, but they were penetrating. Here you see he did a great job getting to the basket, drawing a lot of fouls. The free throw disparity was huge. They attempted 19 free throws versus Chavez attempted only 9. That was because of the driving.
And for Cesar Chavez, Khalif Tate, he was keeping them in at 10 points on 13 shots from the field, but it was all about Laurel and Kirk Hawkins just getting to the hole. 13 points, got to the line 5 times, hit all 5 of his free throws, and again, it was a fast-paced game, back and forth, lots of turnovers, but at the same time, lots of good action. So we are back here on the court for the second half. We're in the third quarter. Laurel with a 34-32 lead. Khalif Tate running the offense. He's on the left side. Over to Blaine. Out to Jacob Long. Inside, Prince right. Short jumper, no good. Laurel with the rebound, and here comes Kirk Hawkins. And Mr. Hawkins getting to the hole, drawing contact yet again.
How fast is that guy? Man, he disappears to the other end of the court before he can blink. He does a great job of drawing contact in the process.
Now, again, I know I need to watch my, comparisons. But there's another speedy number 2 in the Washington, D.C. area that kind of gets up and down the floor. And I'm just saying, I'm not comparing him to John Wall, but there are some similarities. And let's take a look. I mean, just ball control, jump stop, able to change directions. And, you know, he's just been doing that all game.
Yeah, he does a great job of stopping on a dime and changing directions. He missed that free throw there, but he is a really talented young player, like you said.
Blaine, I'm sorry, that was Long, thinking about the long three drives. Doesn't hit the iron. Hawkins. Always probing. Eno, left side. That is such a sweet jumper.
It really is. It's a great 1-2 punch when you have a guy that can create shots for you.
Tate looking to push the pace for Chavez, and we're going to get a foul. Blocking foul on the floor. That one is going to go on Jeremiah Pittman. Oba and Joran checking back in for Laurel.
Eno now has 14 points. He's knocking down some shots.
And that is Khalif Tate. Tried the three, nothing but air. Back comes Laurel. Hawkins walking it up the floor. Laurel is going to get into the half-court set. They're trying to get the ball out of his hands. Matthews down the lane. No. Rebound to Khalif Tate. He's going to push it.
Huge difference in the way these two teams play. Long
with the strong drive, blocking foul, and Jordan didn't have position.
Yeah, that was a strong drive, but they were in transition and didn't even look to go to the basket. They looked to go to the perimeter again.
So we've got Jacob Long at the line. Yeah, if Chavez wants to get, they're in this game, but if they want to, you know, get the lead, they are going to have to find a way to penetrate that Laurel interior defense.
Absolutely. Laurel's doing a great job. Chavez, here on the replay, there you see a strong drive. But earlier in that possession, there was a fast break, and they kicked it out and waited a while for that to actually develop.
Laurel with a 4-point lead. 6 minutes left to go here in the third. Matthews in the corner over to Keyshawn Hill Kearney. He's being double teamed. And there's the turnover, the steal by Marquise Kauser. Khalif Tate, he's going to get fouled by Antoine Matthews. It's going to be on the floor. Chavez ball on the side.
Khalif Tate was trying to do his best Hawkins impression there and get to the hoop. He didn't set up for a jump shot that time.
Well, I tell you, Tate, and we talked about this during the break off camera, he's the one player, as he hits a three, the one player on Chavez's team that can take this game over for them.
Absolutely. He had 10 points in the first half and didn't shoot the ball well there.
And almost forced a steal right there. It was off his hands, out of bounds, Laurel's ball.
Yeah, he can really do it on both ends. To score in double figures in the first half without having your best performance and then come out in the second half and knock down a three is a good sign.
Jeremiah Pittman back in for Laurel. There's a drive by Arthur Prince. We're going to get a charge. And Prince Wright doing a good job drawing that contact and getting the turnover for Chavez. Chavez down by one. They're looking to take the lead. Tate. Hey, good. Short jumper, no good. Rebound to Eno. Hawkins, and there's a near steal, but it's batted back to Eno. And we've got a little bit of sloppy ball. I think we might need to slow down a little bit. Chavez ball.
I don't think either one of these teams like to slow down very often, but definitely some sloppy play. But once again, forced by great defensive pressure. Quick hands from Chavez.
Khalif Tate. Over to Prince Wright for three. Front of the rim, no good. Rebound, and Omari Haygood got in behind, tried to make that pass, and Coach Oxendine wants to talk this over.
Yeah, quick hands again by Chavez. The defensive pressure they put on is incredible, really. I mean, from start to finish. One of their keys was to match the intensity and energy of the other team, but I think it's them that brings the intensity and energy to begin with.
We'd like to remind you to visit jimmyv.org to donate to cancer research. Your donation to the V Foundation funds critical cancer research at prominent cancer centers nationwide. As the great Jim Valvano once said, don't give up, don't ever give up. Make your donation today at jimmyv.org. Sean Parker, Josh Apple, DeMatha High School, 2015 National High School Hoops Festival. This is the first of seven games that we've got today. And we've got the first two. We're kicking it off, and we're having a ball so far.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. This is a really fun game. Exciting stuff from both teams in terms of playing a fast-paced game, defensive pressure. Really, really exciting energy for a game that's played at 10 o'clock in the morning when these kids are usually sleeping.
Hawkins rims out. Right after this game, we've got Riverdale Baptist at West Charlotte from Charlotte, North Carolina. Riverdale Baptist from, and there's an offensive foul. Laurel is going to get it. Riverdale Baptist from Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Like you said earlier, one of nine Maryland schools in this tournament or in this festival.
Yeah, the home state is well represented, as to be expected here at DeMatha.
And we're going to take a look at the last play here.
Yeah, and, he drew the charge. That was a good call. Both teams, like I mentioned throughout the broadcast, are undersized, very guard heavy. And when you have that, you're instead of blocking shots, you're going to try to draw charges, and that's exactly what they did.
Chavez, with that pressure, they're trying to turn Laurel over again. They get the ball back into Hawkins' hands. He spins, drives inside, and that was a good move right there by Hawkins and by Jeremiah Pittman to put it away.
That play shows exactly why they're leading so far. It's only a three-point lead, but that was a perfect play there.
Jumper, Jacob Long, no rebound. Pittman, back comes Laurel. And I tell you, Chavez's mid-range game, part of the reason why they're down, they're not hitting those jumpers. Hawkins, inside, Eno. Prince couldn't get it, back the other way, Chavez. That's Jacob Long. Driving and scoring. And once again, the lead is down to one.
Chavez has a tendency to drop down, you know, 5, 6, 7, 8 points, but then come right back.
Pittman, and there's a blocking foul. Khalif Tate did not like that call, and he let the referee know. He's got to be careful.
right, not a guy that wants to be talking off to the ref. He's too important of a player.
And looking at that last basket right there, I mean, that was a good drive to the hole by Jacob Long.
It's a nice move, way to get inside, which Chavez needs to continue to do to stay right here with Laurel, 1 point down.
All right, and we have a foul on Marquise Kauser. Laurel is going to inbound. 3:41 left to go here in the third quarter. 39-38, Laurel with the 1 point lead. Eno on the left side. That's good. That was only a two. His right foot was on the line.
That's the guy that we compared to Steph Curry earlier, right?
That's right.
he really is shooting well today. He has a nice touch.
Laurel with the rebound, and there's a turnover. Haygood inside. Hooping the harm. He's going to the line. Chavez hanging around. They're down one. They've got a chance to tie this game.
I think Coach Battle at halftime said similar things that I did. They need to get inside, and they've done a better job of getting inside in the second half. And here you see on the replay, they force a steal there, and then it goes straight to the basket as opposed to going to the perimeter and draw a foul. So well done there.
Haygood with the free throw, and we are tied again at 41. Chavez with the pressure again. Eno with a jumper outside. No good. Gets his own rebound. No. And that was Khalif Tate with the rebound. He is pushing it up the floor. Long on the left side for three. No good. Strong rebound by Josh Brown. Back comes Laurel. A lot of physical play in the backcourt. Eno with the short jumper. No. Battle for the rebound underneath. Johnson gets it. Chavez. Long three from Tate, and he drains it. And Cesar Chavez has taken their first lead since early on. It's 44-41, and there's a foul.
Tate's the guy we said that can be the difference maker in this game, and he's starting to catch fire. He's a guy that has 7 threes in one game this year, and he's knocked down two, and that one was especially deep so far.
A good 5 or 6 feet behind the line.
That was NBA range right there. Here you see on the replay. Let's see how far back he is. Nowhere even near the three-point line. That was way from downtown there, so impressive touch.
Laurel. Hawkins. Driving. Contact, and that was a late whistle, but he did get it.
Late whistle, but definitely a foul there. He continues to do it. A good job of drawing contact on these drives. It looks like it's going to be the Hawkins versus Tate show here down the stretch, the two stars on the court.
Two shots. Again, Laurel employing on the free throw line, almost the late stage, the end of the game, and you're trying to pack your defense. They don't put any of their players on the free throw line with the shooter.
It is unusual to see, but it makes sense going against a team like Chavez.
He hits a pair. It's a one-point game. And we have a turnover in the backcourt. Laurel with the ball.
Laurel had all their players at the other end of the court, and Chavez still turned it over with no one there, so big mistake.
I know Coach Battle cannot be happy about that. Kirk Hawkins directing traffic. Brown back to Hawkins. Over to Eno. Brown looking inside for Pittman. Draws the contact, and he's going to the line.
He had no angle for that shot and was really bailed out by that foul call.
Omari Haygood picks up the foul, his fourth. So there are two Chavez Eagles in foul trouble right now. And we are going to go to the replay here.
Yeah, that pass was thrown almost out of bounds, and he had no angle, no way to make that basket, and was bailed out with the foul.
44-43, Cesar Chavez out of Washington, D.C. with a one-point lead over Laurel from Laurel, Maryland. 1:51 left here in the third. Pittman hits the second. We're tied at 44.
What a game to start our day. All tied up.
Laurel led by head coach Torrance Oxendine, former Potomac coach, came over to Laurel as the boys basketball coach and the athletic director. So he's got a bunch of responsibility on his shoulders, flying out directly after this game to the National Athletic Directors Conference.
It's a busy man.
Busy man.
Busy man.
I hope he took his five-hour energy.
He's in his sixth year with the team.
We've got a foul on the play. And Prince Wright is going to the line. He is going to shoot. Chavez regains the lead. The wonderful thing about high school sports, I mean, even, you know, during timeouts, whether there are stoppages in play, whatever, there's always coaching. So even during that free throw, Coach Oxendine had his players over there, and he was instructing them.
Speaking of Coach Oxendine, he was really fired up after that one. You saw a lot of emotion out of him.
He can get quite fired up, and he's a big man. I would not want him angry at me.
No.
Chavez with a one-point lead, looking to extend it. Kicking it over. Khalif Tate in the corner for three, and he got another one.
He's on fire. That's three in the second half.
And Chavez with their largest lead of the game at four. Hill Kearney with the jumper. No good. Rebound underneath. Prince. That ball is being kicked around right now. Chavez. And we're going to get a foul on the floor. And I think they're going to get Kirk Hawkins on that one.
That ball was on the ground a long time, wasn't it? It looked like a football play where no one could pick up the fumble.
It certainly was. It's like a game of hot potato down there. Mike Starks going to the line. He's going to shoot 1-1. And we're going to take a look at Khalif Tate's last three. I mean, in the corner, that's just a wicked stroke. Nothing but net.
Great stroke, but that one was actually on the three-point line. What happened last time? He was about five steps behind it, so that one wasn't as impressive.
Well, you know, he can't.
I guess he would have been out of bounds.
I guess so, yeah.
So.
Free throw is good. And Chavez with a six-point lead. Under 40 seconds left here in the third. And we've got a kickball. And Laurel is going to retain possession.
And is Coach it Malcolm, just me, or did that ball not touch a foot?
To me, it did not touch a foot at all. Coach Malcolm Battle, I mean, he was. I thought he was going to come out all the way onto the floor on that one.
That hit someone's shoulder or an arm or a hand. That it never got anywhere near someone's foot, so that was a questionable call.
Hawkins in the corner. Eno steps in front of the three-point line. Can't get it to go down. Back comes Chavez. Tate pulling it back out inside 20 seconds. He drives. He scores. 8-point lead for Chavez. So exactly what we said Chavez needed to do, as that's inside to Pittman. In order to take the lead, it's happened. Khalif Tate has taken over. Three-pointer that will not go, and we have reached the end of the third. And that quarter was all Chavez.
It was the Khalif Tate show. We said he's the one guy that can carry their team, and he did. He knocked down three threes. He made a shot there at the end, did a great job. Really in the all-around game, so he's starting to really feel it and carry his team.
Well, we've had a ball with this one. We got one more quarter here, but we've got another good one coming up. We've got West Charlotte and Riverdale Baptist.
Yeah, Riverdale is 7-2.
Jeremy Huber here with Josh Apple previewing the matchups of the National High School Hoops Festival at DeMatha. One of the earlier games of the day, Josh, a matchup between Riverdale Baptist and West Charlotte.
Yeah, Riverdale is a local team. They're 6-2 on the season. That will be an advantage because they've played a lot of games. They've had a tough schedule so far this year. They just had an overtime win against Ryken. Before that, they lost to McNamara, another team playing in this tournament, and they're ranked 11th in the Washington Post, so they should have a solid team. And they're facing the only team from North Carolina in West Charlotte. They're 3-2, also have had a tough schedule in the early part of the season, so they're probably better than the record indicates. They have some players to watch in Jalen Knight and Kobe Williams. And a notable alum is Jeff McGinnis, who played in the NBA for 8 years.
Remember, if you'd like to see all 7 games of the National High School Hoops Festival at DeMatha, you can do it for just $9.99 on DMVSTREAM.COM.
All right, we are back. DeMatha High School, home of the 6-time national champion Stags. They are the hosts of the 2015 National High School Hoops Festival. Khalif Tate, 22 points per game. I mean, he's the man for Cesar Chavez.
He is the man. He's made 24 threes this year. He just made 3 in that quarter alone, so his numbers are higher now. And he was really the star of the third quarter.
Hawkins, that jumper partially deflected, and it's going to stay here with Laurel.
And remember, Tate was just 4 of 13 shooting in the first half, so he really found his game there in the third quarter.
So what is Laurel going to need to do in order to regain their footing in this fourth quarter?
It will have to be Hawkins. He's their star. He'll have to create shots for both himself and his teammates and not succumb to the pressure like they just did there.
Another turnover in the corner. Marquise Kauser for 3, rimmed in and out. Rebounded by Anjorin, and back come the Spartans. Hawkins looking inside. Oh, Jeremiah Pittman. He had to be ready for that pass, and he wasn't.
That was a really good pass. Yeah, it was a great look, but he just wasn't ready for it. Unfortunate, because that would have been an easy 2 points. But that was the guy I mentioned. Hawkins has to be able to create both for himself and for his teammates, and he almost did it there.
All right, Steph Curry, I mean Eno checking back in for Laurel. And Khalif Tate out near midcourt. They are not in a hurry with a 6-point lead, looking to set that offense. Mike Starks. Looking at my wrong spotter sheet. Starks. Prince Wright driving, and we've got a charge. That was a charge all the way. I mean, Kirk Hawkins did not move his feet.
Yeah, there wasn't much question there. That was definitely a charge. But it's still a good sign because Chavez is getting to the basket, which they didn't do in the first half. So I think as a coach, you're okay with that foul.
And I mean, you know, we talked about sloppy play on both ends of the court during this game. But it's just, I think that's a byproduct of both teams being very aggressive. Marquise Kauser with his first bucket.
Good timing on that play, as you were saying. Sloppy play, but great pressure. Again, almost another steal.
Laurel's got to be careful and hold on to that ball. And another charge. Chavez on the defensive end making things happen. And that's how they've opened up this 8-point lead.
That was a 5'7 guy right there that took a charge. Again, when you don't have a lot of size, that's how you block shots, was by drawing charges.
And Arthur Prince at the table, ready to check in. Conversation between the referee and Coach Oxendine. And we'll see what's going on here. And so Oba Anjorin is going to be coming out. And I think they were confirming that how many fouls he had. Chavez with an 8-point lead, approaching the 6-minute mark here in the fourth quarter. But as we've seen, Laurel does have the capability to come back. Right now, Chavez looking to hold on to the basketball. Khalif Tate outside, long, and there's a foul. That foul is going to be on Keyshawn Hill-Kearney. And he picks up his 4th foul.
Lots of foul trouble for Laurel. But with no shot clock, you almost have to foul if they're just going to stand around and not take a jump shot.
Well, I mean, we were talking a little bit earlier before the game, and we were talking about no shot clock. And we're talking about that famous Duke North Carolina game that ended 12-10.
12-10. It's amazing what can happen when there's no shot clock.
So the Carolina four corners works, and two Chavez Eagles knocking into each other. Laurel on the fast break could not convert the layup. Eno trying a tough shot behind the backboard. Can't get that to fall. Chavez with the ball, and we've got a timeout. Malcolm Battle wants to talk it over with his team.
We're talking about Chavez needs to slow it down and waste some clock. And as they do that, without even pressure on their face, they just threw the ball away, but bailed out that Laurel didn't score on that fast break.
The hardworking DeMatha Video Broadcast journalism students help bring you all the Stags basketball and football home games, as well as a variety of other events, including the DeMatha Stag Report. The current winter package costs $40, with most of the proceeds going back to DeMatha for equipment upgrades and additions. To purchase the winter sports package, go to www.nfhsnetwork.com, search DeMatha, and look for the support tab in the top right corner of the page. Josh, Laurel now has time as an enemy.
It really is.
More than 5 minutes left.
Really is an enemy, especially without a shot clock. Chavez is going to take their time, which just means that Laurel has to pressure them defensively. They're certainly capable of it, but the problem being that Chavez has great ball handlers and can handle that pressure.
On the floor for Laurel, Antoine Matthews, Kirk Hawkins, Eno, Jeremiah Pittman, and Josh Brown. Cesar Chavez, Greg Blaine, Mike Starks, Prince Wright, Khalif Tate, and Jacob Long, who's bringing the ball up the court for Cesar Chavez. Looking for a little give and go. Long wasn't ready for the pass. Out of bounds, Laurel ball.
That helps Laurel right there. The mistakes Chavez has made lately have been self-inflicted.
Again, that Chavez pressure in the backcourt. Eno with the ball. Laurel keeps it. We have exactly 5 minutes left to go here in the fourth quarter. Cesar Chavez with a 54-46 lead. We've got a foul, and they are going to get Greg Blaine on that. And he's got that smile on his face like, what are you doing?
He was pretty adamant that he didn't commit that foul. There might have been some action with the foot on the trip. I couldn't quite tell, but he's very confident it wasn't him. It was he on the replay.
And so let's take a look here.
There was some contact there. That's a good call. As a ref, you have to make that call.
But I think there might have been just maybe a little bit of acting right there. And looking at this, yeah, he did catch, it looks like he caught him right behind the knee on that. Yeah, right behind the knee, but there was also a little bit of
some acting, but I buy it. I'll call that one a foul.
It's all part of the game.
It's all part of the game, that's right.
All right, so Kirk Hawkins at the line, hits the first free throw. And downs the second. It's a 6-point game. And I think if Laurel can keep it within two possessions, going down the stretch, they've got a shot.
Especially with a guy like Hawkins who can be a difference maker.
And Eno who can hit those threes. Laurel with an aggressive man-to-man here. Prince Wright gets it over Starks. Back out to Jacob Long. You've got to think they're going to get that ball to Khalif Tate. And that ball is batted out of bounds by Kirk Hawkins. It's going to stay with Cesar Chavez.
You saw a trap there. The man-on-man coverage is great, but Chavez has such great ball handlers that it's not going to force a turnover unless you get a trap like that.
Right on the inbound, gets it to Tate. Back over to Wright. Closing in on 4 minutes remaining here. Chavez spreading the offense, kicking it over. Starks up top to Prince Wright. He drives with the right hand and scores. And now Laurel coming back. They've got to be careful with that ball, and they turn it over again. Tate on the break. Inside, Prince Wright, no, misses the jumper. Back comes Hawkins. He's going to push it. 1-on-3 and scores it.
Man.
He's fearless.
Tate and Hawkins, I still want to see that race. That would be fun to watch.
We got to make that happen.
We got to make that happen. Man, he just flew down the court.
I think we can make a few bucks on that. What do you think?
I think so.
Sell out the newly christened Maryland Stadium and take care of that. Khalif Tate in the corner. Prince Wright thought about the three. Pulls it down. Back up top. Long.
That was a smart decision.
Starks being guarded by Hawkins. 56-50. Under 3 minutes left. And that was Mike Starks drawing the contact. He'll go to the line.
It's almost night and day difference from what you saw in the first half with Chavez and they're attacking the basket.
All right, and we're gonna take a look.
Now, this is the Hawkins play. He just flies down the court again, can stop, change directions, and finish. Really impressive stuff from him on these fast breaks.
And they've really got, they have to get the ball to him going down the stretch.
They do. He's the key. Now down 7.
And looks like we have a substitution. And Coach Oxendine going to try to get some instruction there while that happens. Starks hits. Lead back up to 8. Inside of 3 minutes. Hawkins driving. No. Gets his own rebound. Back up in the tall trees. No. Out of bounds.
He didn't score there, but that was still fun to watch. Every time he touches the ball, it's fun to watch.
Again, in the previous possession, I used the term fearless, and he really is. He just has absolutely no fear, almost no conscience when he's going inside.
Absolutely. I mean, you're right. It looks like he doesn't care if it gets blocked or if he gets fouled. He's just going for it.
Eno steps back for 3. Off the rim, no. Battle for the rebound. Loose ball. That's going to go to Chavez.
That was a tough shot there from Eno, but he did manage to get free of the defender and was pretty open for that look.
Antoine Matthews checking back in for Laurel. 2:35 left. If Laurel is going to make that move, they've got to do it now. Prince Wright bringing up the ball. Tate in the corner, back to Wright. Back out. Chavez content to keep possession right now, and that was a costly turnover. Hawkins back the other way. Prince Wright with the reach-in foul. That was not a smart play going inside.
No, all Chavez needs to do is hold the ball there, and they threw a tough cross-court pass, and Hawkins grabbed it and again showed his speed. The only way to stop him is to foul him, which Chavez ultimately did.
Because, again, with some teams, an 8-point lead with 2 minutes, yes, you know, you've pretty much got it. But with this team, you've got Hawkins, you've got Eno that can hit those threes. Laurel can make up that difference in a heartbeat, and you're putting Hawkins, a very good free throw shooter, on the line.
He's had a lot of trips to the line in the second half. It seems like almost every other play, that's where he finds himself.
Hawkins hits 2, and it's once again a 2-possession game, 58-52. Laurel with the pressure, and it's out of bounds off of Prince Wright. Laurel turns him over.
Wow.
I think Prince Wright thought he was going to get that foul call.
Yeah, he seemed surprised he didn't get the call. There was some contact, but it's hard to tell from our angle if there was, in fact, a foul.
Oba Anjorin, the big man, back in for Laurel. That ball deflected, but Matthews has it. He's going to drive. Oh, somebody got bailed out with a foul. That was a turnover waiting to happen right there.
That's a 4-point
Jacob Long picking up his fourth foul. Antoine Matthews at the line.
Foul trouble all around for both teams at this point.
All right, let's take a look at this last foul. And was it a foul? Let's take a look here.
I actually thought that was a travel. I don't think it was a foul. To me, I thought it was a travel, but out of bounds, same result.
I mean, there were two or three things right there. Basically, referees could have called anything.
It could have been a foul, a travel, or out of bounds. They went with out of bounds.
And free throw shooting is getting Laurel back into this game. They have cut this lead to 4 with just over 2 minutes left. And we are right at the 2 minute mark now, and we've got a foul.
That one was probably the right call. It's hard to tell from our angle again whether he hit the ball or he hit the player's hand.
And I know Coach Oxendine did not want that. You know, it's only 4 points. Solid defense, you know, can get you another possession and can cut the lead even further. But they send Jacob Long back to the line. And we're going to take a look at this last play. And what are we seeing here?
It looks like a foul to me. It's hard, again, to tell from that angle from behind. But to me, that looks like the right call.
So Jacob Long hitting the first free throw. 59-54, 1:59 left to go in the fourth.
Big miss.
All right. And back the other way, Chavez. They get it down underneath the Prince right. It looks like our the clock that is displayed on the screen and the one that we have in the arena, just a couple of ticks off. We're showing 1:46 left here. As Khalif Tate goes to the line. Shooting 2. And Chavez, they can put this game away, you know, assuming that Laurel is going to start fouling if they hit the free throws.
Free throws have been a problem for them the whole game. In the first half, they only made 4 of 9. And you wouldn't think Tate, such a high profile player for them, would miss 2 free throws in a late game situation.
Hawkins. Over to Prince. And we've got a timeout. Coach Oxendine, it looked like he was trying to save that possession. He thought maybe it was headed toward a turnover, and he wants to talk it over.
Good idea there. It was getting a little out of control, a little sloppy. So the timeout came at the right time for them, and they're still within reach. 5 points, far from over.
1:34 left here. Chavez with the 5-point lead. We like to remind you that right after this game, we have got the Lions of West Charlotte, North Carolina, going up against the Crusaders of Riverdale Baptist out of Upper Marlboro, Maryland. Riverdale Baptist, one of the most solid and storied programs in the region. And after that, Largo and Bowie, a battle of two Prince George's County, Maryland schools at 2 o'clock. McNamara and Eleanor Roosevelt at 3:45. Virginia Episcopal, St. James, 5:30. Paul the Sixth and API Prep out of Texas at 7:15, and then the main event, DeMatha against Henry Wise out of Prince George's County. That is the nightcap at 9 o'clock.
The last two games really are both the main event. Should be pretty special, so make sure you tune in for those games later tonight.
All right. Again, this is the National High School Hoops Festival at DeMatha High School. A minute and a half left. Laurel trying to get back into this game. Eno for 3. No. Strong rebound. Jeremiah Pittman over to Oba and Joran. He draws the foul. He's going to go to the line.
This fourth quarter has been dominated by free throw shooting. It's going to come down to who makes their free throws.
All right, we're going to go to the replay. We're going to take a look at that last foul on Anjorin.
That play came off a solid pass, freeing up his teammate, and he went straight to the basket and drew the foul.
He hits his first free throw. It's a 4-point lead. Again, with Laurel's defense, if they can cut it to one possession, they are still in this.
Absolutely.
Second free throw rims in and out. Chavez with the rebound. And Laurel is going to foul.
Wow, some intensity there.
Yeah, I think Prince Wright took a little bit of exception to that contact. He's going to go to the line. He's going to shoot two. At this point in the game, though, you've got to expect that you're going to get that contact.
Absolutely. The contact's going to come. He needs to control his emotions and just know that that's going to happen. But the refs, they've been a little busy this afternoon or this morning, haven't they?
They certainly have. And the old ball stuck in the corner of the rim. That's no good. We've got 1:16 remaining here in the fourth quarter.
The Chavez free throw shooting continues to really struggle.
It really does. I mean, they were only 4 for 9 in the first half.
They've attempted a lot more in the second half, but they've also missed a lot.
Chavez with a 5-point lead, so it's still a 2-possession game here for the Spartans. A near turnover, but underneath, Oba and Joran hits. It's a 3-point game. Here comes the Laurel press. Chavez, Khalif Tate able to break it. He's going to get the foul. They're going to get, I think, Eno on that one.
For Laurel, probably not the guy you want to be fouling right now, although he did miss a pair just moments ago.
So Khalif Tate, an excellent game here for Chavez. He led their effort here in the second half. 1:03 remaining. Hits the first free throw. The lead is 4.
That's more what you expect to see out of their star player. And there he knocks them both down. So big free throws right there for Khalif Tate to spread the lead out to 5 points.
And Chavez with that pressure. And they are going to get, looks like they're going to get Marquise Kauser on the foul. And Kirk Hawkins going to go back to the line.
These refs might have their whistles die before the end of this game. Too much use.
It's a good thing they don't use the whistle with the P in it anymore. Otherwise, that P could have cracked from hitting the inside too much. And I think I just showed my age talking about a whistle with a P in it.
That might be before my time, but I believe you that that's a thing.
Kirk Hawkins hitting the first one. The lead is 4. We've got 1:01 left. This is the second free throw. That was clutch. That could have knocked that lead down to 3, and a 3-pointer could have tied it. But Chavez with the ball inside 1 minute. They are going to play keep away. And there's a foul by Kirk Hawkins on Jacob Long. Off in the distance, I see the Riverdale Baptist team, and I see a couple of players from West Charlotte checking out the last few seconds of this game. They are coming up next.
I think it's more that they're eager to get started warming up than trying to watch this game.
Yeah, I think you're right. They might be thinking, okay, guys, get off the
get
court.
Off
it's
the
time
court.
For us.
Stop fouling. It's our turn now.
63-58, 47.2 seconds left to go here in this one. Jacob Long at the line for his second free throw. Both teams in the double bonus. They'll be shooting 2. Hawkins. Eno. Driving baseline. Short jumper. No. Rebound. Batted out. And that's going to go to Chavez. It went in between Keyshawn Hill, Kearney's legs, and he wasn't able to corral it.
Through the 5-hole. Right out of bounds, and the coach Oxendine, the look on his face. Just shook his head.
Nice ice hockey reference.
Yeah. I'm well-rounded.
And we've got a foul. 30.8 seconds left. Stonebridge, the state final today, right?
In football, yes.
In football, yes.
Stonebridge and Westfield, two local teams are playing football state finals today at UVA.
I just made a stream of consciousness ice hockey football reference.
Yeah.
Don't ask.
Stonebridge is a hockey and a football power, so a logical connection. They did win the state championship in both sports when I was there. So
thanks for bailing me out on that.
Yeah, no problem. Stonebridge plays at 1 o'clock and Westfield at 4 o'clock today down in Charlottesville.
All right, so we wish the best of luck to them. Jacob Long at the line. It's a 6-point lead. So at this point, yeah, Laurel's going to have to jack up some threes down here. Back out to Eno. Chavez was anticipating that. Out of bounds, Laurel keeps it. And Laurel is going to call a timeout right here. Talk about their strategy here in the last 24 seconds. 24.4 seconds left. Chavez is up 64 to 58. And what do you think Coach Oxendine is telling his team over there right now?
At this point, they have to start jacking up those threes, like you said. And, I mean, they don't really have much time to try to pressure the ball, maybe 1 or 2 seconds. But if you don't get a steal, you have to foul right away on the defensive side. Your options are limited at this point with 24 seconds left, down by 6 points.
All right, looking at Chavez's upcoming schedule, they've got a couple of games here in the next few days. They've got Brook Point on the 18th, Covenant Life on the 21st. Then they go for their holiday break, and they come back for Edmondson Westside on the 29th before they hit the New Year's slate, three games in the first 12 days of the new year. Laurel trying to get back in this game, and there's a turnover right there. Jacob Long with a good athletic play, knocking the ball to himself, getting it. He takes the foul. 22.8 seconds left. I think he can pretty much ice this if he can hit his free throw.
I have a feeling that's not what Coach Oxendine asked for in the huddle.
Laurel, once again, they've got some games coming up here on the 15th. They take on High Point. They're at Bladensburg. Then they host Duval. And then they are going to host Reservoir on the 28th after the holiday break. And then they host the Spartans Holiday Classic before they travel to Eleanor Roosevelt on January 5th. And that's going to be a tough game. Eleanor Roosevelt, one of the very good athletic programs in Prince George's County in just about every sport, and they are tough in basketball every year.
Very tough in basketball, and they'll be here today. They're playing today, so you can check them out to see what they have to offer this year.
Jacob Long on the line. 7-point lead for Cesar Chavez. Looking to put this game away for the Eagles. He hits the second one. Laurel has got to get it up the court quickly and get a shot off. 3-pointer by Kearney. No good. Out of bounds. Laurel keeps it. 14-8. And the sand might have just run out of the hourglass for the Spartans.
I know they were in a hurry there, but not necessarily the guy you wanted to take that shot. You have to find your good shooters in that situation. But when you're pressed for time.
Brown inbounding. And Joran battling underneath with Prince Wright for position.
Keyword battling. They were going after each other down there.
And Joran gets it. Got to put up a shot quickly.
Wasting a lot of time.
Inside. Pittman with the layup. It's good. But they just don't have enough time. 7.6 left. And Coach Oxendine is going to take a full timeout for Laurel. Cesar Chavez with a 6-point lead. I tell you, it's, Cesar Chavez in the second half, they really picked it up. And, you know, we said at halftime that, if Khalif Tate could pick things up and they start hitting some free throws, that that they could take over this game, and that's exactly what happened.
That's exactly what happened. The third quarter was the Khalif Tate show. He took over, knocking down threes, forcing some steals. He got to the basket, did everything he needed to do, and then they got the lead and haven't relinquished it here in the fourth quarter.
Chavez inbounding it, getting it up court. Jacob Long with the ball, 2 seconds left. Laurel is going to commit a foul.
With 0.4
seconds. 0.4
seconds.
And Coach Oxendine, he's at the end of the bench. I thought he was going to walk off the floor.
He does not look happy.
Talking to somebody on the side like, I don't believe that just happened. 0.4 seconds left here. Jacob Long on the line. Chavez is going to come away with the win. Missing the free throw. I think you still want to, even in the situation you got the game sewn up, you know, you want to get that repetition. You want to hit those free throws.
Clearly a problem for Chavez going forward will be making free throws. They're going to come away with a win today, but something they need to work on in practice.
Hits the second one, inbounds the ball. That is going to be your ball game. And Cesar Chavez is going to come away with a 67-60 win over Laurel.
Really exciting game. Great way to start off the morning here in the 10:30 hour. Two teams that really force the tempo and get after each other defensively.
It really was. I think, you know, if the rest of the slate is as entertaining and fast-paced as this one, we're going to have a good day.
We are going to have a good day. Next is Riverdale and West Charlotte, and that should be a really exciting contest between two talented programs.
All right, we're going to take a quick look at our highlights from this game. And we've had quite a few highlights. Taking a look here at Laurel. And a good strong move right there inside by Arthur Prince. Again, Kirk Hawkins driving to the basket all game long, able to knock down shots. But Khalif Tate engineering that offense. I mean, he was hitting jumpers. He was hitting threes. He was inside, you know, and really took over. But here we go with Kirk Hawkins again. He's scary fast.
He really is scary fast. These highlights are from the first half, which was more dominated by Laurel, even though the scoreboard was close. Here you see Chavez forcing turnover, something they did throughout the game. Really great defensive pressure. But here Hawkins gets by the pressure and draws the foul.
And again, Khalif Tate,
man. How deep was that one?
That long three-pointer. I tell you, that shows you the range he has. And here he is again over in the corner. Just draining threes. And that was really when he started heating up in this game.
That was the third quarter when he took over, and that really was the difference in the game.
And again, turnovers, you know, just costly in that game. And down the stretch, that's really what cost Laurel.
That was the difference maker. Turnovers for Laurel, even though they did a great job throughout the game of getting to the basket, it was the turnovers that ultimately did them in.
All right, we're going to put the lid on this game. Chavez coming away with a 67-60 victory. We are going to step away. When we come back, we're going to have West Charlotte and Riverdale Baptist in Game 2 of the 2015 National High School Hoops Festival here at DeMatha on the DMVSTREAM.com.